Hey guys, and welcome back to a brand new gear review. Well, if you're into photography, then you obviously have a camera and possibly even more than one. And it's most likely that you've got a bunch of lenses lying around as well. Now that stuff is expensive, so you want to have it protected very well against, you know, the elements and so forth. And for that reason, we're going to be diving into a full review of the Lowepro, the Nova 200 All-Weather Model 2, and see if that is a suitable choice for your gear. Okay, here we go. Alright guys, well, that was already a lot of information. Hopefully that gave you a good idea, and now it's time to jump into the nitty-gritty, okay? Now, first of all, full disclosure, Lowepro sent this back over for me to review, so thank you Lowepro. They did not pay me for my opinion, okay? So you're gonna get an honest review from me, and when it comes to bags, I certainly have an opinion, right? Now, what I like about Lowepro is their quality. I mean, they're famous for it, and when you buy a Lowepro bag, you don't expect it to, break, tear, or whatever. And if it does, you know, they'll take care of you for sure. So I'm not worried about that at all, right? Now, my initial thought when I saw this bag, the Nova 200 AW2 on photographs, is that it was tiny. I can assure you I was very, very wrong. Although it doesn't look like a huge bag, there's plenty of gear you can take with you, okay? Now, if you look at the interior bags on the front there, you have all sorts of little mesh pockets and zippers and clips where you can put in your cell phone, cables, you know, SD cards, USB sticks, all that kind of small stuff, right? But even if you want to put in, let's say, battery packs and that kind of thing, it's no problem at all. And then you got a lot more storage on the flap there, if you will. And there you got separate pockets for your SD cards, as you can see. Again, a lot of zippers. They are all protected with those little corners there. And yeah, the overall quality is just looking awesome, okay? Now, the test, of course, I wanted to see if I could change the dividers. There are quite a few. I would even go as far as to say a bit too many for my taste, but keep in mind that, you know, there's no such thing as too many dividers, right? If you are using this bag, let's say for lenses only, it's perfect. You can take a bunch of lenses. You can see that it's padded everywhere. Even the top cover there is very thick. So I'm not too worried when somebody stacks something on top of the bag that my gear will damage. So it's really solid there, and like I said, you can adjust all those dividers, okay? So I put it to the test. Obviously, I took some of my gear and started to put it in there. A pretty big Nikon is in there. I got my 300 millimeter Tamron lens. I got a big fisheye lens in there, my microphone, and a couple of other lenses. And I didn't even fill all the side pockets, and you can see that it goes in there easily. If you rearrange things, you can put in, I would say, two pro DSLRs and some additional lenses, okay? So looking at the cost of this bag, which based on dollars or euros would be in the range of, I would say, probably something like 145 bucks or 135 euros, I think it's a very, very good deal. It's a completely high quality bag. And it's a good fit for me because, like I said, I love my camera bags, and this is one to keep, okay? So that's my personal opinion, up to you, of course, but I would definitely check it out, okay? See you guys next time. Bye.